What's the sound people most often make when they eat your dessert?
Yeah, a sound of satisfaction. We've been around long enough to hear a lot of different sounds. Some unique ones I'm not going to say.
Janice Wong has been described as Singapore's queen of desserts. The pastry chef is known for her colourful chocolates, intricate pastries, and large canvases of edible art. Yes, chocolate you can literally pluck off the ceiling and eat. Our lunch is at Gunter's, a French restaurant in Purvis Street. She has chosen to eat here because the chef used to be her mentor when she was starting out some 15 years ago. Like others in the F&B industry, Ms. Wong's business has been affected by COVID-19. When the pandemic struck earlier this year and the lockdown looked imminent, she knew she had to do something quickly to keep her outlets afloat and her employees working. Her answer? Pre-mixed baking kits, which were snapped up as people stayed home and many, including me, took to baking.
So Janice, you know, how has this year been for you with COVID and all?
The first initial stage, so much to do. We had a lot more work because we had to move everything online. Then after that, we had to very quickly also plan, okay, how can I bring the Janice Wong experience to people's homes? Just because we are really locked in, you know? Then I was like, okay, let's try to come up with like, you know, a very easy pre-mix solution. And so we took 20 of my favorite things like madeleines, financiers, banana cake, pancakes, everything you can think of, cupcakes, you know, every variety. And just to really do a simple step. Yeah, I'm very thankful that we managed to do that and had positive reviews.
So in terms of different palates, how would you describe the Singaporean palate versus the Japanese or the Korean?
The Singapore palate, I would say, is very fickle.
Really?
Because they go where it's very popular or Instagrammable. But yes, our palates are very sophisticated because we can tell from a good and a bad ingredient or a good and a normal ingredient. And people here are willing to definitely pay more for higher quality. They always say, right, make your calories count, right? Yeah. So the Japanese palate, they're able to appreciate bitter, sweet, sour, umami at different levels. Singapore palate might not be able to appreciate like bitter in desserts or too acidic. So the Koreans are very, it's a very good market for us as well. I think it's very unique.
How has COVID changed the F&B scene?
We're all very united now. I mean, we have the SG F&B hashtag, you know, and all the F&B industry, we're all in this group chat together, which is so unique. And we're really supporting each other. What's also really good is that we're doing a lot of collaborations. From different types. So I was doing something with Jigger and Pony during the lockdown, and we came up with like chocolates and cocktail pairing for people in their houses. I did something also with Potato Head, where we do our first dessert bar pop-up in Singapore for 13 years. And it's great because they come from a very different perspective, and their drinks are very different from our drinks. So it's very nice for me to really also see how far the pairings can go.
So what would you say to a young chef who wants to be like you? What advice would you give?
The first thing I say is really to find your identity. For me, it's about innovation. It's about sweet experiences. So it's a very clear, distinct identity. So stay true to your identity, but, you know, of course, be aware of the trends and also adapt. I think my success is because we've been able to adapt to the different environments. And now, of course, people want things, whether it's Instagrammable, whether it's technology. We try our best to deliver that. I mean, we do a lot of chocolate desserts or ice creams. And dessert is always a craving. And once you satisfy that craving, you get that mmm sound.
Thank you very much for having lunch.
Oh, thank you for inviting me.